In this video, how to clone and replace a MacBook Pro disk, and install the latest OS 10, El Capitan. The first step is to clone your Mac disk. Create a backup to prevent data loss. Open Disk Utility, in Yosemite or earlier versions. Create and select a partition in your backup disk, then go to File and create a new blank image. Now choose a name and where to save the disk image. Give a logical name to the image, and on size, define the exact size of your Mac drive. Select predefined amount, or a custom size. On format type, select macOS 10 journaled. Let the rest settings as default and click to create the new blank disk. Now, if you have more than one partition, select all of them, or the disk itself. Then, click on Restore, and you will note that the source is the same as your Mac drive. That will be cloned to the blank disk image we already created. Click on Restore, then in Erase, and it will start cloning your Mac disk. Now, if you don't need to define custom settings like format type or size, just select your Mac disk and click on Create New Image. Give it a name, choose where to save the image, and you can leave the rest settings as they are, compressed and no encryption, then click Save to start the backup. Now, if you're already using OS 10 El Capitan, follow the same steps as before. That is to create a new blank image, or create a new image from an existing folder. And this is how to backup your data, or clone your Mac disk. Now the second step is to download the latest OS 10, El Capitan. Go to apple.com and download OS 10. On the top menu, click on Mac, and enter on OS 10 El Capitan. Click on Upgrade Now, and the App Store window should open. If not, click on View in Mac App Store and download. Then, with OS 10 El Capitan application downloaded from Apple, go ahead and grab your brand new disk. For this video I'm going to use a Crucial BX100. This BX100 is known for its capabilities. The performance is good for all workloads, the price and its energy efficiency is certainly a great upgrade option. You also need an external hard drive enclosure, with a 2.5 inches USB SATA serial port. Capably to connect your hard drive with a solid state drive. Now, without the bottom case of your Mac, access the hard drive and replace it with the new disk. Take out these two screws, pull it out, and unplug the eSATA connector. Connect your SSD, and then secure it in place. The BX100 comes with a stick closure. Stick it on the disk, finish by mounting the unit, and then, close the bottom closure of your Mac and you're done. Now with the latest OS 10 application on the external hard disk, connected with the SATA head, plug it in the USB port on your MacBook. Start up your MacBook Pro, while pressing the C key to boot from the USB port, and your Mac should boot from the external drive. Now, when booted, go ahead and open Disk Utility. Select the internal drive, and create a partition. Give it a name, and on format type select macOS 10 journaled. And on options tab, Confirm that the partition table should be a global unique identifier. Then click OK, apply to create the partition, and then the SSD will be ready to install the new operating system. Now you have two options: a fresh install of the operating system on the new SSD disk, and then restore your data, or restore your clone Mac hard drive, and then install the latest OS 10. If you just want to do a clean install of Apple's operating system, go ahead and open the OS 10 El Capitan applications or from the launchpad, and click continue. Agree with terms and conditions, and then click to show all disks. Select the SSD drive, click install, type your credentials, and it will begin to install OS 10 El Capitan in your new Mac. Now instead of a fresh install, you want to restore all your Mac hard drive. All you have to do is to create the partition in the new SSD disk, and then restore the cloned data from the backup disk to the partition itself. On Disk Utility, select the new disk, go to Edit, and create a new partition. Define your settings and hit Apply. Then, from the backup drive, open the cloned Mac image, and paste all your data to the new SSD partition. And this is how you replace and install OS 10 El Capitan in a brand new disk. Now, if you need to create a bootable pen drive with the latest OS 10 operating system, watch this next videos.